Jamie. Welcome back to my channel. It's about 2 p.m. on Sunday, March 22nd, and I just wanted to give it a little bit of an update on what's been happening the past few days. So tonight, I believe it's at 8 p.m., the ban on non-essential workers working goes into effect. So that means that I can technically go to work until 8 p.m. today. It's Sunday, and I don't usually work on Sundays, so I'm not. But because I'm not an essential employee, I work from an R&D facility, I'm not in a plant, even if I were in a plant, not everybody in the plant is necessarily considered essential. But yeah, since I'm a non-essential employee, I have to work from home starting tomorrow, which is fine. I mean, that's what I've been doing this past week anyway. I think it's great that it's going into effect. I was a little worried that it would mean restaurants would be shutting down, but restaurants aren't, so at least restaurants are staying open. That's going to be good for them, hopefully. So just wanted to update on that. That's the state here. We do have a couple of cases in the county now. I believe we have 3 that I'm aware of, at least, and one of those is someone who lives in my town, but I don't think they've been at work for about a week. It was kind of unclear. Obviously, all these posts in the news that are saying, yeah, there's a case in this town, don't want to tell you who it is just because they don't want you know, privacy violations, all that sort of thing. So I don't know who it is. They mentioned that the person was at a car dealership on Friday the 13th. My guess is it's someone who works at that car dealership. I have no idea if that's actually true. Maybe it was just someone who went to try to buy a car. I don't know. Regardless, I was not at that car dealership that day. But who knows? Maybe that person affected a whole bunch of other people that I've seen at Wegmans, at Aldi, at Walmart, who knows? So yeah, I think that's the main update. Just trying to stay sane. I mean, I guess there's been totally different stages of grief. I mean, I really do think at first the appropriate word was grief. I mean, I was, even though I'm not missing, you know, my prom or anything that only happens one year when you're a certain age, you know, I'm in the workforce. Anything that's not happening this year can happen next year. Kentucky Derby party, I can go to that in 2021. I wasn't actually going to go to that this year, probably, anyway, but regardless. You know, whatever these events that I'm seeing on the, you know, Facebook from my favorite distilleries, breweries, bars, whatever, they'll come back next year. And it's important to keep that in mind, you know, to remind myself of that. And pretty much anything that I want to do this year, I can do next year. I think that's helped me grieve a little bit less. I've been reading a lot. I've been doing some coloring. Don't know where this came from. I think an aunt gave it to me. Glad I have it because distraction. Otherwise, I've been trying to stay sane by listening to podcasts. Watching a lot of videos, I don't think that helps with sanity though. I did the Northern Lights painting that you saw in yesterday's video. And then just, you know, trying to get things done that were on my list that I mentioned on Friday. I've been working on bleaching the crust. I'll have an update in a day or two when it's pretty much done. Then I've been really craving banana bread. So I'm trying not to go to the store. I went last to the store on Monday, today's Sunday, so about a week. I'm good on all the essentials. I really want to make banana bread, and I don't have bananas. I do have canned pumpkin, so I might just make pumpkin bread and see if that makes you happy. Anyway, stay safe, stay sane. Talk to you in my next video. Bye!